In the meeting, a team of officials from the Ministry of Health, led by Engineer George Otim, presented a plan of how the new Masindi General Hospital will look after reconstruction is done. Otim has informed the stakeholders that the hospital will be built in phases for a period of 3 years, adding that in this financial year, 10 billion shillings was allocated to commence the construction.
We've done a preliminary assessment. This hospital requires a total of 50 billion Uganda shillings to carry out civil works, which will involve a brand new OPD stroke administration block. We are going to also construct inpatient department, a complete one. All these are going to be storied.
Engineer Otim adds that the work will cost 50 billion shillings, noting that 32 billion shillings will be for civil works, while 18 billion shillings will be for equipment. He noted that the construction works are going to be undertaken by Uganda People's Defense Forces Engineering Brigade, and work is expected to start in 1 month's time.
2022-2023, the government of Uganda has provided 10 billion for a phased construction, which is going to start immediately. We finished the feasibility study. We want to survey the land, open the boundaries. We are going to do some engineering investigation to ensure that the foundation that we have designed for this facility is able to carry out a storied building. We are not going to go through the other lengthy procurement, which takes 6 months to get a consultant, another 6 months to get a contractor, and then 2 years you're still doing procurement.
Engineer George Otim called upon the district leaders and other stakeholders to ensure that there is no shoddy work.
The casual workers to come from the society. We expect some skilled workers in this community to join this construction, which may take 1, 2, 3 years. If at the end of the day we have a very good hospital, which is going to be a model hospital, by the way, and then we have also imparted skills, because we're coming with these skills, with new skills from out in this facility. If we have the youth skilled by training on the job and they're able to work for themselves, that will be the best thing.
Dr. Vincent Katsime, the medical superintendent for Masindi Hospital, noted that the hospital has come at a time they are grappling with insufficient space, and currently the females are sharing the ward with the males.
It looks, it's an improvised two sections. We have the waiting mothers and any other sick mothers who get some other medical related conditions in pregnancy. So we've cut in the smaller ward to cater for two areas. That's the sick and those that are in active labor. So whatever you are seeing is an improvised sort of way to ensure that we utilize this very small ward. Nonetheless, we have hope that now that government has intervened in a way of constructing a new hospital, we think this kind of condition shall come to an end.
According to the residents, the reconstruction of the hospital will lead to the improvement of service delivery in the area. Government has been promising to construct for us a hospital in vain. Our Mzee seems to have finally fulfilled the pledge. Now we ask that if it needs him to come to the ground, let him come and see what they are going to construct. We love Mzee, but he should also give us more doctors, nurses. Also, they should create for us a ward that caters for patients that need a referral, because for us, we are poor. The Masindi District LC5 chairperson Cosmas Pierhanga says that the hospital has been in a sorry state, and the biggest challenge has been separating the outpatient and the inpatient services.
It's worth 32 billion, and then the medical equipment, about 18 billion, and that's about 50 billion. And we are so much grateful to His Excellency, the President of the Republic of Uganda, to our area member of parliament, Honorable, who put this before the floor of parliament, so that this budget has been finally allocated, and we are so much grateful as people of Masindi.
The current Masindi Hospital is one of the oldest hospitals in Uganda, which was constructed in 1920s as a dispensary for Uganda Railways. Currently, it is serving over 500,000 people who come from different districts such as Nakasongola, Kiriandongo, Bulisa, Masindi, and different parts of Hoima. Report compiled by Ambrose Niwagabaka Toto for the news.